Hillary Clinton decided not to go and address her supporters.
She puts a closed early sign on the front of the
real
store.
Reason Hillary disappeared was because she was
critics have accused Clinton of hiding from reporters.
I'm back.
He was not fit to be president.
Help us fight!
Hillary Clinton's corruption is on a scale we have never seen before.
Nobody should be fooled. It won't be easy or quick, but make no mistake, we will prevail.
What I'm about to show you in the next 5 minutes will be extremely difficult to watch, but it will also save your life. You're about to hear a private briefing about the truth behind the 2016 election and Hillary Clinton's one final desperate act still to come. It also exposes a corrupt conspiracy involving Clinton, a secret society of gangsters, and other high-ranking government officials, and for the last 23 years, it's remained a total secret until today. To be clear, the people involved never expected the inner workings of their plan to see the light of day. And if it weren't just for one tiny mistake, it would have remained buried forever. So if you're ready for the truth, keep watching. But if you don't think you can handle it, close this video now before you hear what I'm about to say next. This will be your only opportunity to hear my warning and take action to protect yourself and your family. Ready? Here goes. Did Hillary rig the 2016 election all the way back in 1993 and in exchange allow a sinister act to kill 31,000 American seniors that year and more every year after? Impossible? Trust me, your liberal friends and family won't be able to deny a thing once you show them the information I've been able to uncover. It's a secret plan cooked up by Crooked Hillary herself that I've identified as Executive Plan 5. And it's a scheme so elaborate and far-reaching, it can only be defined as high treason. Here was the plan. On January 20th, 2017, Hillary was supposed to place her hand on the Bible and take the presidential oath of office, not as the victor of an honest and fair election, but as a liar, a traitor, and the conspiracy mastermind of a rigged election. Fortunately, you and I both know how her story ended. She failed to become president, and thank God for that. While President-elect Trump was watching his electoral votes flood in, Hillary went into hiding, practically disappearing off the face of the earth. Why? Because she knows this isn't a simple case of he won, she lost. No, there's so much more to the story than that, and the treason goes deeper than you or I could ever imagine. So while most Americans are breathing a sigh of relief that Trump will serve as our next president, what 99.98% of them won't know is the uncomfortable truth. The outcome of this election, arguably the most important one of our lifetime, was actually planned 23 years ago, behind closed doors, in a top-secret location. And even though Hillary has all but disappeared now, her entire sinister plot is still unfolding, and putting millions of American lives in jeopardy every single day. Worse yet, Trump, Pence, or any of the high-powered politicos in D.C. are absolutely powerless to stop her. How do I know for sure? I'll explain everything, but let me start by introducing myself. My name is Dr. Alan Spreen, and I work for an organization just outside Washington, D.C., a patriotic group that monitors our government for exactly this type of thing. I can't reveal my sources, but a network of insiders gives me special access to this kind of information. We've uncovered a lot of dirt over the last 19 years, but nothing this huge. I might even be putting myself at risk to publish this report today. I've actually been tracking this story for years, following paper trails, checking facts, and gathering a mountain of evidence along the way. But even I didn't want to believe that this kind of thing could actually happen in America until I saw Hillary's speech when she accepted the Democratic nomination. It was her smug smile and the way she waved like a queen at the crowd through the sleeves of her $12,000 pantsuit jacket. She knew she'd already won. I decided right then and there that I wasn't going to let her get away with it, and I know you won't either. Truthfully, even the craziest of left-wing libnuts won't be able to deny the proof at 6:18 of this video. that Hillary has co-signed the most devastating American scandal this country has ever known. That's right, co-signed. Because even though I truly believe Hillary is a force of evil against our great nation, she isn't in this alone. In fact, during my investigation, I uncovered proof of a shadowy organization operating strategically behind the scenes and manipulating Hillary's career with her full blessing. My colleagues and I call that secret organization the Clinton Cartel, and they're every bit as power-hungry and despicable as Hillary herself. Since all the way back in 1993, the Clinton Cartel has been Hillary's ally on every rung of the political ladder, moving all the right chess pieces to buy her elections, knowing that starting in 2017, with Queen Hillary running the show, she'd be returning the favor. That's right, in exchange for delivering her presidency on a silver platter, she'd look the other way while giving the cartel full access to run one of our government's biggest agencies for limitless profits. Here was the plan. When Hillary's scheme went into effect in 2017, the cartel would have unprecedented access to our government and a direct path to your health and money. With their plan set in motion, she was guaranteed to win. Guaranteed. Only they didn't pull it off. And now the cartel, hungrier than ever, still wants to be paid back, even if it's at the expense of American lives. I'll explain exactly what I mean, but here's the part that will really blow your mind. Clinton swore up and down the campaign trail that the cartel are actually her enemies. She's absolutely shameless. She publicly denounced them and says they're out to take advantage of middle-class Americans. And they are. But behind closed doors, she's been greedily accepting their money and their help for decades. Friend, what you're about to see next proves exactly why she was always unfit to be president and why we could never allow her into the White House. Here are the facts. When Bill first assigned Hillary to lead his task force on national health care reform in 1993, she immediately put 33 corporate power players on her team. Now, these were some real heavy hitters across several industries that she knew had the muscle to get things done in D.C. and weren't afraid to get their hands dirty in the process. It was a real deal with the devil, to be sure, but this group stood to make a killing. Because with the approval of the new health care bill, they were promised a payout to the tune of $10 billion in new revenues. Yep, that's billion with a B. Fortunately, you and I both now know how that ended. Thankfully, the bill was destroyed before it ever got off the ground, and Hillary's teammates never got to cash their checks. But failure has never stopped Hillary. She's had plenty of it, but her lust for power is never ending. And she knew that in our country, money can still buy power, but you need lots of it. So she decided to form a secret alliance with this group of corporate fat cats. And with nothing more than a secret meeting and brief handshake to seal their pact, the Clinton Cartel was born. They vowed to never speak of their arrangement again. But I was watching, and what you're about to hear next is a matter of public record, the undeniable proof of the cartel's work. Fast forward to Hillary's 2000 Senate bid. The cartel funneled $86,875 in cash into her campaign, ensuring her victory. During her re-election in 2006, they upped the ante and pumped $157,015 into her campaign. And again, she won. Then came the 2008 presidential election, when the cartel gave her $174,000 in cash. The cartel didn't even care if Hillary lost in the primaries. They had their sights on 2016 the entire time. Fast forward to 2015, when Hillary announced that she was running for president. And now the cartel went all in, to the tune of $7,054,871. But they didn't stop there either. Trying not to draw much attention to their partnership, they privately made additional contributions to the Clinton Foundation, ranging from $1 million to $5 million each. In total, it's estimated that Hillary has accepted over $10.8 million in cartel dirty money since 2000. And that's only including what's publicly shown on her books. With that kind of money buying all the votes she needed, the scheme was practically foolproof, until her carefully laid plan was outed in the final hours before the election. Hillary rightfully lost, and the cartel was once again left with their pockets turned inside out. But that just made them even angrier. So, who exactly is this faceless cartel? And why should we still be afraid of them, even after Donald Trump becomes president? And most importantly, How can you protect yourself and your loved ones? From my experience, I've found Clinton's cartel to be an extremely cunning and dangerous team. They work in secret and consist of highly influential figures, lobbyists, and even corporate executives. Now, that might not sound intimidating at first blush, but in partnership with Hillary, they've already launched Executive Plan 5 with one simple goal: manipulate American politics and the American people for billions in pharmaceutical drug profits, and no one would ever catch on. What's even more terrifying is that this group is not made of politicians. Look, Trump has promised to drain the swamp in D.C., but these folks are too powerful to be touched. So even without Hillary on their side, they can still have unprecedented power to influence our government's health care laws and policies. Take, for example, the FDA. The cartel has been funding that group for years. They practically own it already. How? In just 2015 alone, the FDA received $97,605,000 in, quote, standard fees from the cartel, all to allow more prescription drugs to flood the market, making billions for the cartel. And it's only going to increase. A lot. In fact, it should rocket to well over $100 million a year in money paid to the FDA, allowing the cartel to continue to push their poison pills for billions in profit. And the worst part is, they're selling us prescription drugs that are completely unnecessary, and many of them are deadly. Did you know the FDA receives more than 2 million consumer complaints about prescription drugs every single year? It gets worse. It's estimated that over 350 Americans are dropping dead every single day from taking their own prescribed medications. That means in the short time you've watched this presentation, two more Americans have died from the cartel's work, and seniors are at the most risk. But maybe you're sitting here and saying, that will never be me. Then let me ask you, are you over the age of 55 and taking a prescription drug? Does your spouse take any medications? More than 31,000 seniors will die this year from legally prescribed medications. But what can you do? Your well-meaning doctor prescribes them for high blood pressure, cholesterol, diabetes, whatever it is. And you need them, right? Well, that's what the Clinton cartel wants you to believe. But today we're exposing their most dangerous lie. You see, the organization I work for is called the Health Sciences Institute, or HSI. We're an independent think tank of patriotic American doctors, scientists, and researchers, and we are fighting back against Hillary and her slimy cartel by exposing their biggest lie ever, starting with five words they never wanted you to hear. You don't need prescription drugs. Not when there are already very real cures and treatments for the diseases that plague us: Alzheimer's disease, arthritis, MS, heart disease, even cancer. Cures they've actively covered up for the last 23 years. And today we're exposing everything and revealing every disease-curing secret so they lose and you win. Like a cancer cure that beats chemotherapy and starts killing cancer cells in just hours. Covered up by our own government, you won't believe this outrageous scandal. The easy secret to reversing Alzheimer's and dementia with the power to roll your brain's clock back 12 years. How did this one get buried? The truth comes out today. The only solution that erases arthritis pain and rebuilds arthritic joints. Pain vanishes in as little as 7 days. Are you ready for a brand new outlook on life and zero pain? Want deep, restful, healing sleep night after night without the danger of deadly sleeping pills? You'll be amazed by this new sleep wonder and just how dangerous the pharma stuff secretly is. There's a deadly symptom of heart failure that your doctor doesn't know. This is must-read information to save you from a fatal heart attack. Plus, there's a simple solution for protecting your heart now if you know where to look. You see, there are true cures from all over the world that work as well as or better than prescriptions, but with no lousy side effects. In fact, in many countries around the world, these therapies are prescribed by doctors, and reports are flowing in that they're curing grateful patients from cancer, heart disease, Alzheimer's, and more. But why not here in the greatest country in the world? Well, it interferes with the cartel's money machine. You see, these are all natural disease treatments discovered by top scientists right here on God's green earth. But you can't patent a plant extract or an herbal disease treatment. And if you can't patent something, you can't sell it for big profits. So why would the cartel even waste their time? It makes